Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to have you help me welcome an incredible businessman, an incredible teacher, an incredible author, and an incredible individual to lecture and share with thousands of people all across the nation and all across the globe. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robert Stevenson.
Good afternoon. I said, tomorrow morning about 5 o'clock, I'm going to get up. I'm going to take the two mugs out of my room. I'm going to bring them downstairs. I'm going to lay them on the counter. You're going to fill them up with coffee. I'll pay you $5 a mug. I just want coffee. Then she gives me the finger. See, the finger is a very important communication device in this world. Your name, sir, is?
Jerry.
Jerry, when you have the finger in your face, don't you understand things a whole lot better? She says, sir, let me make this perfectly clear. You can't get coffee in our hotel 4-7. What don't you understand about that? Now I'm a highly educated customer on what? A mission. Folks, I've been at these hotels. I know what goes on behind the scenes. So what do? The next morning I get up. I put on jeans and a t-shirt. I don't comb the hair. I figure let's go make a visual. Envision me going across the lobby of this beautiful hotel. I pass them all. I walk into the kitchen area. Guy looks at me and goes, who are you? I said, don't worry about it. He says, what do you want? I said, coffee. He said, well, sir, I happen to be responsible for the coffee. I said, great. Folks, in hotels this big, they're not small machines. They're large. I walk up to the coffee machine. I'm like, Nirvana. He says, how many cups do you want? I said, 6. He said, 6? Dude, you really love your coffee. I said, no, 2 are for me, 4 for the front desk. He said, what? I said, you don't want to go there, son. Envision me going across the lobby of this beautiful hotel, jeans, t-shirt, hair all askew. I walk up to the front desk. I lay 4 cups down, and what do I say? Tell Mary you can get coffee before 7 in this stupid hotel.
Thank you.
Why do I tell you the ridiculous story? All of a sudden, Charles calls me up and says, Rob, we're thinking about having our conference at the hotel next year. Have you been there? Yes. Should we go? What do I say? No. How many people I do business with? 1. Ladies and gentlemen, I learned a long time ago it rolls downhill. Management evidently didn't understand that the gatekeeper of their organization was the person at that front desk who should have said, when would you like coffee? That also doesn't mean the customer's always right. Sometimes we ask for things that we shouldn't have or you can't deliver. And you tell them that. We don't do that. But the point that I'm trying to make is that one right there. It's called the 8-16 rule. If you do a good job, they'll tell 8. You do a bad job, they'll warn 16. But they'll warn them about your organization. I mean, when you go to the awards banquet, and all of a sudden they give out the top awards. And let me give you an example, because I've done this at a lot of awards banquets. I mean, all of a sudden they'll say the number one person. And that person will be down there, and they'll be at their table. And the next thing you know, the CEO of the corporation announces it. The lights go off, and everybody starts jumping up and down. And they're sitting there, and they walk up, and they grab the award. And they're standing in front of everybody feeling wonderful, great, fantastic. And as they're walking off the stage, you know what management's thinking? What have you got going for me next year? It's not even cold in your hand. You know what we call it in business? Hero to zero. Folks, enjoy it. Feel the accolades. But then understand, you got to go deliver again. And if you didn't get it, you can get it next year. When you want to create rapport with a customer, one of the greatest things that you can do is cause them to laugh, have a good time, smile. It drops the gatekeeper. We'll talk about that tomorrow. But have some fun, folks, because you know what it says to me about you? You've got the passion. You enjoy what you're doing, and you want to share it. And that's exactly what they're saying. Here's an industry that has enormous competition, and they're always making a profit. See, when we used to hire somebody, I'll segue a little bit. I don't know if this is totally legal, but we would do this, okay? We would come up with this list. Now think about the list. Do you want somebody that's energetic, happy, upbeat, knowledgeable, prompt, cheerful, pleasant, fast, efficient, friendly? How about cordial, attentive, kind, go-getter, accommodating, gracious, professional, polite, courteous, and helpful? I want those kind of people. Well, we would hand people this list when we were trying to hire them, and we would say, which ones aren't you? There's some really stupid people in this world. They'll be sitting there going, oh, I'm not that, and I'm not that, and oh, I'm not that, and I'm really not this side, you know? And we go, and so for some reason, we didn't hire them, okay? It's like, here's 20 cents, go buy a clue. You don't have one, all right? You know, but when you look at it and you say, wait a second, that's a pretty neat list. My statement to you is, which ones aren't you? But that's not the point that I'm trying to make. The point that I'm trying to make is this. I want everybody to have your left over your right or your right over your left. Switch. Is that not disgusting? Oh, no, keep your hands up. I want you to hold it that way because you're going, oh, that is wrong, okay? You just don't do it that way, all right? You're sitting there saying, that's not the way you do it. Do it that way for 6 months. The other way is different. So you start looking at making people change. You start thinking about what you've got to create as far as your people and who you're going to do it. And sometimes you've got to appreciate that one small fact. Sometimes it takes a while before any change will feel right. Even the suggestions that are going to be made to you in this meeting today, or tomorrow, or the next day, or the rest of the year.